Namo Namaha. Welcome back, students. This is the third session of ours based on the poem Vyayamaha Sarvada Pathyaha. We have seen first 7 verses. In today's session, we are going to see the last 4. So let's get started with the verse number 8. Here is the verse. I'll read it out. Vyayamohi sada pathyo balinam snigdha bhojinam. सच शीते वसन्ते च तेषां पथ्यतमस्मृतः. I hope you have understood the pronunciation of words. Now let's see the words with sandhihi or sanyogah from the given words. Vyayamohi pathyo balinam. Sach are the examples of sandhihi. Let's see the dissolution of these words. Vyayamo hi, the dissolution is vyayamaha plus hi. Pathyo balinam, the dissolution is pathyaha plus balinam. And sacha, the sandhi vichhedaha is saha plus cha. Now let's see the anvayaha of the words. Here is the anvayaha. Snigdha bhojinam balinam hi vyayamaha sada pathyaha bhavati. Shite vasante cha sahatesham pathyatamaha smrutaha. Now let's try to understand the meanings of the words and the translation of the verse. Vyayamohi sada pathyaha. Vyayamaha, exercise. Sada, always. Pathyaha means beneficial. Balinam, of strong people. Snigdha bhojinam means of those who eat oily or greasy food. Sahacha shite vasante cha. Shite, in the winter. Vasante, in the spring season. Tesham pathyatamaha smrutaha. Pathyatamaha, extremely beneficial. Smrutaha is considered. The translation of the verse is, exercise is always beneficial to those who are strong and who have greasy or oily diet. And it is considered to be extremely beneficial to them, especially in winter and in the spring season. In the verse, it is said that exercise is particularly beneficial to those who have huge and strong bodies and who eat greasy or oily food in all the seasons of the year. But in the winter season and in the spring season, it is highly necessary for them. During this period, exercise is extremely helpful for their bodies. I hope you have understood the verse. Now let's see Visheshan Vishesha Padani from the given words.
Here are the Visheshan Vishesha Padani. The word Pathyaha is the Visheshanam of the Vishesham Vyayamaha. And the word Snigdha Bhojinam is the Visheshanam of the word Balinam. Now let's see the next words.
सर्वेषु ऋतुषु अहरहः पुंभीरात्महितैषिभिः बलस्यार्धेन कर्तव्यो व्यायामो हन्त्यतोऽन्यथा.
लेट्स सी द वर्ड्स विथ संधिः और संयोगः फ्रॉम द गिवन वर्ड्स. द वर्ड्स विथ संधिः और संयोगः आर
सर्वेषु ऋतुषु अहरहः पुंभीरात्महितैषिभिः बलस्यार्धेन एंड कर्तव्यो व्यायामो हन्त्यन्तोऽन्यथा.
लेट्स सी द डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ दीज वर्ड्स.
सर्वेष्व ऋतुष्व अहरहः, द डिसोल्यूशन इज सर्वेषु प्लस ऋतुषु प्लस अहरहः. पुंभीरात्महितैषिभिः, द डिसोल्यूशन इज पुंभिः प्लस आत्महितैषिभिः. बलस्यार्धेन, द डिसोल्यूशन इज बलस्य प्लस अर्धेन. एंड कर्तव्यो व्यायामो हन्त्यन्तोऽन्यथा द डिसोल्यूशन इज कर्तव्यः प्लस व्यायामः प्लस हन्ति प्लस अन्यथा.
नाउ लेट्स सी द अन्वयः ऑफ द वर्स. आत्महितैषिभिः पुंभिः सर्वेषु ऋतुषु बलस्य अर्धेन व्यायामः कर्तव्यः अतः अन्यथा हन्ति.
Now let's try to understand the meanings of the words and the translation of the verse.
Sarveshu rutushu, it means in all the seasons. Aharahaha, every day. Pumbhihi, by people. Atmahitaishibhihi, means by those seeking their own good. Balasya ardhena, to the half extent of their capacity. Kartavyah should be done, should be taken. Vyayamah, exercise. Hanti, it means it may prove harmful. Atah, therefore. Anyatha, otherwise.
The translation of the verse is, in all the seasons, people seeking their own good should take physical exercise every day, only to the half extent of their capacity, as otherwise it may prove harmful. I hope you have understood the translation.
The question arises that what amount of exercise is good for us? The answer to this question is given in this verse. It is said that a man seeking his own good should take physical exercise every day only to the half extent of his capacity, which is called balardha, as otherwise it may prove harmful to him. I hope you have understood the verse. Now let's see visheshan vishesha padani from the given verse.
Here are the visheshan vishesha padani. The word sarveshu is the visheshanam of the word rutushu, and the word atmahitaishibhihi is the visheshanam of the word pumbhihi. Now let me take you to the next verse.
Rudhisthana sthito vayur yada vaktram prapadyate vyayamam kurvato jantos tad balardhasya lakshanam.
Let's see the words with Santhihi or Sanyogah from the given verse. Rudhisthana sthito vayur yada and kurvato jantos tad balardhasya are the examples of Santhihi. Let's see the dissolution of these words. Rudhisthana sthito vayur yada, the dissolution is rudhisthana sthitah plus vayuhu plus yada, and kurvato jantos tad balardhasya, the dissolution is kurvatah plus jantohu plus tat plus balardhasya. Now let's move on to the anvayah.
यदा रुधिस्थानस्थितः वायुः वक्त्रं प्रपद्यते व्यायामं कुर्वतः जन्तोः तद् बलार्धस्य लक्षणम् अस्ति.
Now let's try to understand the meanings of the words and the translation of the words.
रुधिस्थानस्थितः means in the hard place. वायुः means air. यदा when, vaktram means mouth, prapadyate reaches, vyayamam kurvato jantoho means of a person doing exercise, tat that, balardhasya of balardha, it means the half extent of one's capacity, lakshanam means symptom or indication. The translation of the verse is, when the air in the heart place reaches the mouth, that is an indication
or symptom of balardha of a person doing exercise.
The definition of balardha is given in this verse. It is said that when the air in the heart place reaches the mouth, that is an indication or symptom of balardha of a person doing exercise. It means when a person starts exhaling heavily from the chest, it is an indication that half of his energy has been burned away. I hope you have understood the verse. Now let's see Visheshan Vishesha Padani from the given verse.
Here are the Visheshan Vishesha Padani. The word Rudisthana Sthitaha is the Visheshanam of the Visheshyam Vayuhu, and the word Kurvataha is the Visheshanam of the word Jantoho. Now let's see the next verse.
Vayo Bala Sharirani Desha Kalashanani Cha Samiksha Kuryat Vyayamam Anyatha Rogam Apnuyat.
Let's see the words with Sandhihi or Sanyogaha from the verse. The words with Sandhihi or Sanyogaha are Desha Kalashanani, Kuryad Vyayama Manyatha, and Rogam Apnuyat. Let's see the resolution of these words. Desha Kalashanani is an example of samas which has internal sandhi. The dissolution is Desha Kala plus Ashanani. Kuryat Vyayama Manyatha. The dissolution is Kuryat plus Vyayamam plus Anyatha. Kuryat plus Vyayamam is an example of Sandhihi, and Vyayamam plus Anyatha is the example of Sanyogaha. Rogam Apnuyat is also an example of Sanyogaha, and the dissolution is Rogam plus Apnuyat. Now let's see the Anvayaha of the verse.
Vayo Bala Sharirani Desha Kala Ashanani Cha Samiksha Eva Vyayamam Kuryat Anyatha Saha Rogam Apnuyat.
Now let's try to understand the meanings of the words and the translation of the verse.
Vayo Bala Sharirani. Vayaha means age, Bala means strength, and Sharira means physique or body. Desha Kalashanani Cha. Desha means country, Kala time, and Ashanam means food. Samiksha means taking into consideration. Kuryat, it means one should do. Vyayamam, exercise. Anyatha, otherwise. Rogam apnuyat, rogam, disease. Apnuyat, one may get.
The translation of the verse is, while doing exercise, one should take into consideration one's own age, strength, physique or body, as well as country, time and food, as otherwise it might bring on some disease.
One's own age, strength, body, diet, as well as the season of the year and the physical nature of the country are the factors which should be taken into consideration before taking the physical exercise, as otherwise it might bring on some disease. I hope you have understood the verse.
Here ends the explanation of the poem. Students, the exercise or the abhyasaha based on the poem should be solved by you as homework. We will discuss the answers in the next session. Dhanyavadaha, punarmilamaha.